Question 1. The use of which type of instrument is mainly confined within laboratories as a standardizing instruments? मतलब कि ऐसे कौन से instruments हैं जो laboratories में as a standardizing instruments use होते हैं? So the answer is A. Absolute instruments. The use of absolute instruments is mainly confined within laboratories as a standardizing instruments. Question 2. Which of the following instrument indicate the instantaneous value of the electrical quantity being measured at the time at which it is being measured? मतलब कि ऐसे कौन से instrument है जो electrical quantity की instantaneous value को दर्शाते है सिर्फ उसी time के लिए? So the answer is B. Indicating instrument. Indicating instrument is the instrument which indicate the instantaneous value of the electrical quantity being measured at the time at which it is being measured. Question 3. Which instruments are those which measure the total quantity of electricity delivered in a particular time? So the answer is B. Integrating instruments are those which measure the total quantity of electricity delivered in a particular time. Question 24. Which of the following are integrating instruments? मतलब कि integrating instrument मतलब कि ऐसे instrument those indicates electricity delivered in a particular time. So the answer is D. Ampere hour and watt hour meters are the integrating instrument because they can display ampere consumption per hour and watt consumption per hour. Question 5. Resistance can be measured with the help of. The answer is E. All of the above. Means resistance can be measured with the help of A. Wattmeter, B. Voltmeters, C. Ampere meters means A meters, D. Ohm meter and resistance bridge meters. Resistance can be measured with the help of all the above instruments. Wattmeters, voltmeters, ampere meters, ohm meters and resistance bridges. Question 6. According to applications, instruments are classified as. The answer is C. Both A and B. Means according to applications, instruments are classified as A. Switchboard and B. Portable. So the answer is C. Both A and B. Question 7. Which of the following essential features is possessed by an indicating instrument? मतलब कि indicating instruments में ऐसे कौन से essential features required है? So the answer is D. All of the above. Means which of the following essential feature is possessed by an indicating instrument? So the answer is A. Deflecting device, B. Controlling device and C. Damping device. So the answer is D. All of the above. Question 8. Which device prevents the oscillation of the moving system and enable the latter to reach its final position quickly? So the answer is C. Damping. A damping device prevents the oscillations of moving system and enables the latter to reach its final position quickly. Question 9. The spring material used in a spring control device should have the following properties. The answer is E. All above the properties. Means the spring material used in a spring control device should have the following properties. The answer is A. Should be non-magnetic, B. Must be of low temperature coefficient, C. Should have low specific resistance and D. Should not be subjected to fatigue. Question 10. Which of the following properties a damping oil must possess? The answer is E. All of the above properties. Means which of the following properties a damping oil must possess? The answer is A. Must be a good insulator, B. Should be non-evaporating, C. Should not have corrosive action upon the metal of the van, D. The viscosity of the oil should not change with the temperature. So the answer is E. All of the above. Question 11. Question 11. A moving coil permanent magnet instrument can be used as a which device by using a low resistance shunt? So the answer is A. Ammeter. A moving coil permanent magnet instrument can be used as a ammeter by using a low resistance shunt. Question 12. A moving coil permanent magnet instrument can be used as a flux meter. The answer is C. By eliminating the control spring. Means a moving coil permanent magnet instrument can be used as a flux meter by eliminating the control springs. Question 13. Which of the following devices may be used for extending the range of instruments? The answer is E. All of the above. Means which of the following device may be used for extending the range of instruments? So the answer is A. Shunts. B. Multiplier. C. Current transformers. D. Potential transformers. So the answer is E. All of the above. Question 14. An induction meter can be handle current up to? The answer is D. 100 amperes. An induction meter can be handle current up to 100 amperes. Question 15. For handling greater currents induction, what meter are used in conjunction with? The answer is B. Current transformers. Means for handling greater currents induction, what meter are used in conjunction with current transformers? Question 16. Induction type single phase energy meters measure electrical energy in? The answer is C. Kilowatt hour. Means induction type single phase energy meters measure electrical energy in kilowatt hour, kWh. Question 17. Most common form of AC meters met with everyday domestic and industrial installations are? The answer is C. Induction type single phase energy meters. Question 18. Which of the following meters are not used on DC circuits? The option is A. Mercury motor meter. B. Commutator motor meter. C. Induction meter. D. None of the above. So the answer is C. Induction meters. Induction meters are not used on DC circuits. Question 19. Which of the following is an essential part of a motor meter? The option is A. An operating torque system. B. A braking device. C. Revolution registering device. D. All of the above. So the answer is D. All of the above. Means which of the following is an essential part of motor meter? The answer is an operating torque system, a braking device, a revolution registering device. Question 20. A potentiometer may be used for? The answer is E. All of the above. Means a potentiometer may be used for A. Measurement of resistance. B. Measurement of current. C. Calibration of ammeter. D. Calibration of voltmeter. Question 21. Which is an instrument which measures the insulation resistance of an electric circuit relative to earth and one another? The answer is B. Meager. Means meager is an instrument which measures the insulation resistance of an electric circuit relative to earth and one another. Question 22. The household energy meter is? The answer is C. An integrating instrument. The household energy meter is an integrating instrument because it is record the total energy consumption. Question 23. The pointer of an indicating instrument should be? The answer is A. Very light. Question 24. The chemical effect of current is used in? The answer is A. DC ammeter hour meter. The chemical effect of current is used in DC ammeter hour meter. Question 25. In majority of instruments, damping is provided by? The answer is C, AD currents. Means in majority of instruments, damping is provided by AD currents. Question 26. An A-meter is a? The answer is A, secondary instrument. An A-meter is a secondary instrument. Question 27. In a portable instrument, the controlling torque is provided by? The answer is A, spring. Means in a portable instrument, the controlling torque is provided by spring. Question 28. The disc of an instrument using AD current damping should be? The answer is C, conducting and non-magnetic material. Means the disc of an instrument using AD current damping should be conducting and non-magnetic material. Question 29. The switchboard instruments should be mounted in a vertical position. The answer is A, should be mounted in a vertical position. Question 30. The function of shunt in an A-meter is to? The answer is A, bypass the current. The function of shunt in an A-meter is to bypass the current. Question 31. The multiplier and the meter coil in a voltmeter are in? The answer is A, series. The multiplier and the meter coil in a voltmeter are in series. Question 32. A moving iron instrument can be used for? The answer is C, both DC and AC. A moving iron instrument can be used for DC and AC, both. Question 33. The scale of a rectifier instrument is? The answer is A, linear. The scale of a rectifier instrument is linear. Question 34. For measuring current at high frequency, we should use? The answer is C, thermocouple instrument. Means for measuring current at high frequency, we should use thermocouple instrument. Question 35. The resistance in the circuit of the moving coil of a dynamometer wattmeter should be? The answer is C, high. Means the resistance in the circuit of the moving coil of a dynamometer wattmeter should be high. Question 36. A dynamometer wattmeter can be used for? The answer is A, both DC and AC. A dynamometer wattmeter can be used for both DC and AC. And also moving iron instrument used for similar, means AC and DC both. Question 37. An induction wattmeter can be used for? The answer is B, DC only. Means an induction wattmeter can be used for DC only, because AC current cannot provide induction due to the changing of frequency. Question 38. The pressure coil of a wattmeter should be connected on the supply side of the current coil when? The answer is A, load impedance is high. Means the pressure coil of a wattmeter should be connected on the supply side of the current coil when load impedance is high. Question 39. In a low power factor wattmeter, the pressure coil is connected. The answer is B, to the load side of the current coil. Means in a low power factor wattmeter, the pressure coil is connected to the load side of the current coil. Means if the pressure coil of wattmeter should be connected on the supply side of the current coil when the load impedance is high, and if the low power factor wattmeter, the pressure coil is connected to the load side of the current coil. Means if the power factor is low, pressure coil is connected to the load side, and if the impedance is high, the pressure coil is connected to the supply side. Question 40. In a low power factor wattmeter, the compensating coil is connected. The answer is C in series with pressure coil means in a low power factor wattmeter, the compensating coil is connected in series with pressure coil. Question 41. In a three-phase power measurement by two wattmeter method, both the wattmeters had identical readings. The power factor of the load was? The answer is A. Unity. Means in a three-phase power measurement by two wattmeter method, both the wattmeter had identical readings. The power factor of the load was unity. Question 42. In a three-phase power measurement by two wattmeter method, the reading of one of the wattmeter was 0. The power factor of the load must be? The answer is B, 0.5. Means in a three-phase power measurement by two wattmeter method, the reading of one of the wattmeter was 0. The power factor of the load must be 0.5. Question 43. The adjustment of position of shading band in an energy meter is done to provide? The answer is A, frictional compensation. Means the adjustment of position of shading bands in an energy meter is done to provide frictional compensation. Question 44. An ohmmeter is a? The answer is B, moving coil instrument. An ohmmeter is a moving coil instrument. Question 45. When a capacitor was connected to the terminal of ohmmeter, the pointer indicated at a low resistance initially and then slowly came to infinite position. This shows that a capacitor is. The answer is B, all right. Means when a capacitor was connected to the terminal of ohmmeter, the pointer indicate a low resistance initially and there slowly came to infinite position. This shows that the capacitor is all right. Question 46. For measuring a very high resistance, we should use? The answer is C, meager. Means for measuring very high resistance, we should use meager. Question 47. The electrical power to meager is provided by? The answer is B, permanent magnet DC generators. The electrical power to meager is provided by permanent magnet DC generator. Question 48. In a meager, controlling torque is provided by? The answer is C, coil. In a meager, controlling torque is provided by coil. Question 49. The operating voltage of meager is about? The answer is D, 100 volt. The operating voltage of meager is about 100 volt. Question 50. Murey loop test can be used for location of? The answer is C, both the ground fault and the short circuit fault. Means Murey loop test can be used for both the place for ground fault as well as short circuit fault. Question 51. Which of the following device should be used for accurate measurement of low DC voltage? The answer is B, DC potentiometer. DC potentiometer is device should be used for accurate measurement of low DC voltage. Question 52. It is required to measure the true open circuit EMF of a battery. The best device is? The answer is C, DC potentiometer. Means it is required to measure the true open circuit EMF of a battery. The best device is DC potentiometer. Question 53. A voltage of about 200 volt can be measured? The answer is B, a DC potentiometer in conjunction with a volt ratio box. Means a voltage of about 200 volt can be measured with a DC potentiometer in conjunction with a volt ratio box. Question 54. A direct current can be measured by? The answer is B, a DC potentiometer in conjunction with a standard resistance. Means a direct current can be measured by a DC potentiometer in conjunction with a standard resistance. Question 55. To measure a resistance with the help of a potentiometer, the answer is B, not necessary to standardize the potentiometer. Means to measure a resistance with the help of potentiometer, it is not necessary to standardize the potentiometer. Question 56. A phase shifting transformer is used in conjunction with. The answer is B, Drysdale potentiometer. Means a phase shifting transformer is used in conjunction with a Drysdale potentiometer. Question 57. Basically, a potentiometer is a device for. The answer is A, comparing two voltages. Means a basically potentiometer is a device for comparing two voltages. Question 58. In order to achieve high accuracy, the slide wire of a potentiometer should be. The answer is A, as long as possible. Means in order to achieve high accuracy, the slide wire of potentiometer should be as long as possible. Question 59. To measure an AC voltage by using an AC potentiometer, it is desirable that the supply from the potentiometer in taken. The answer is C, from the same source as the unknown voltage. Means to measure an AC voltage by using AC potentiometer, it is desirable that the supply from the potentiometer in taken from the same source as the unknown voltage. Question 60. The stator of phase shifting transformer for the use in conjunction with an AC potentiometer is usually has. The answer is B, two phase winding. Means the stator of phase shifting transformer for the use in conjunction with an AC potentiometer usually has a two phase winding. Question 61. In an AC coordinate potentiometer, the current in the phase and quadrature potentiometer are adjusted to V. The answer is A, out of phase by 90 degrees. In an AC coordinate potentiometer, the current in the phase and quadrature potentiometer are adjusted to be out of phase by 90 degrees. Question 62. A universal RLC bridge uses. The answer is B, Maxwell-Wien bridge for measurement of inductance, and modified DeSantis bridge for measurement of capacitance. Means a universal RLC bridge uses Maxwell-Wien bridge for measurement of inductance and modified DeSantis bridge for measurement of capacitance. Question 63. For measurements of on high voltage capacitors, the suitable bridge is. The answer is C, scattering bridge. For measurements on high voltage capacitors, the suitable bridge is scattering bridge. In an Anderson bridge, the unknown inductance is measured in terms of known capacitance and resistance. Question 65. Wagner earthing device is used to eliminate error due to. The answer is B, A, electrostatic coupling. Wagner earthing device is used to eliminate error due to electrostatic coupling. Question 66. For measurement of mutual inductance, we can use C, Heaviside bridge. For measurement of mutual inductance, we can use Heaviside bridge. For mutual inductance, Heaviside bridge. Question 67. For measurement of inductance having high value, we should use. The answer is C, Hayes bridge.
For measurement of inductance having high value, we should use Hayes bridge. Means high value of inductance, Hayes bridge is used. Question 68. If the current in a capacitor leads the voltage by 80 degree, the loss angle of the capacitor is, the answer is A, 10 degree. Means if the current in a capacitor leads the voltage by 80 degree, the loss angle of the capacitor is 10 degree. Question 69. In a scarring bridge, the potential of the detector above earth potential is, the answer is A, a few volts only. Means in a scarring bridge, the potential of the detector above earth potential is a few volts only. Question 70. To avoid the effect of stray magnetic field in AC bridges, we can use, the answer is A, magnetic screening. Means to avoid the effect of stray magnetic field in AC bridges, we can use magnetic screening.